In this lesson, we will cover the concepts of benefit-cost ratio and return on investment. We also have few example problems at the end of the lesson. Let's get started. Benefit-cost ratio, as the name implies, is the ratio of benefit to cost. Benefit is the gain from the project, the cash inflows. Cost refers to the investments made for the project, the cash outflows. We will take an example to understand this concept. We have a project that will last for 2 years. Cash flow is minus $100 for year 0, minus $50 for year 1, and plus $800 for year 2. Negative cash flow in year 0 and year 1 is the cost. Positive cash flow in year 2 is the benefit. Next, we will find the present value of these cash flows to capture the time value of money. We will assume 10% as the rate of return for this example. Present value of minus $100 at time 0 is minus $100. Present value of minus $50 in year 1 is, for year 2, the present value is. Let's calculate the BCR. Benefit is the sum of present values of all positive cash flows. It is $499. Cost is the sum of present values of all negative cash flows. It is 100 plus 39 or $139. Notice that we have ignored the negative sign. Absolute values are considered for both benefit and cost. The BCR is 3.6. This means benefit is 3.6 times the cost. For every $1 of cost or investment, the benefit is $3.6. We should definitely undertake this project. Let us look a little deeper into this. We will consider three scenarios for BCR. First, BCR is less than 1. Second, BCR is greater than 1. Third, BCR is equal to 1. When BCR is less than 1, it means benefit is less than the cost. Obviously, we reject the project. When BCR is more than 1, benefit is more than the cost. We should accept this project. What happens when BCR is equal to 1 and benefit equals the cost? When we calculate the BCR, we make assumptions. Assumptions about future cash flows, about costs and the benefits, based on what we know at that point of time. We try to be as precise as possible, but future can never be described with 100% accuracy. Now imagine that we accept a project with BCR equal to 1, and the actual cost goes just a bit more than the planned cost. BCR will become less than 1, and we will be losing money. Projects with BCR equal to 1 or very close to 1 are inherently risky and should be rejected in most cases. In summary, BCR is a profitability index that should be greater than 1 for a viable project. Let's move to the next topic, return on investment. ROI is also a profitability index and is a ratio of return to investment. Return is the net gain, benefit minus cost. Investment is the cost. Benefit is the sum of present values of all positive project cash flows. Cost is the sum of present values of all negative cash flows. Let us go back to the example that we used for benefit cost ratio. We already have the present values of all cash flows. Cost is 100 plus 39. That is $139. Negative sign is ignored. Benefit is $499. ROI is benefit minus cost divided by cost, or 360 divided by 139. We get 2.59 or 259%. It is common to represent ROI in percent. What does this number mean? Return is 2.59 times the investment. If we invest $1, we get a return of $2.59. Definitely a great project to invest in. Next, we will try solving few problems. You are working on a business case for a project. The return on investment for the project is 30%. The project sponsor has requested for the benefit cost ratio also. Which of the following should be your response? A. As we already know the ROI, we don't need the BCR. B. We cannot calculate the BCR with the current information. C. BCR is 1.3. D. NPV is a better approach than the BCR. Please pause the video and try to find the correct choice. Alright, the ROI is 30%. Benefit cost ratio is not given. We will look at the choices now. The first one is, as we already know the ROI, we don't need the BCR. What do you think? ROI and BCR, both are ratios. Can we say one of these is better than the other one? No, that's not true. Each provides us a different view. ROI tells us how much net gain, benefit minus cost, or return we can expect for every dollar of investment. In finance terminology, we can say that the focus is on the bottom line. BCR, on the other hand, tells us how much gain or benefit we can expect for every dollar of investment. The focus is on the top line. Choice A is definitely incorrect. Let us skip options B and C and move to D. This choice is comparing NPV with BCR. Is NPV the better approach? NPV gives us the net gain or return at time zero, the absolute dollar value. BCR is benefit per dollar. Each approach provides us a unique view about the project. D is incorrect. Going back to B and C. B says we cannot calculate BCR, but C gives us a value for BCR, 1.3. Let's see which one is correct. ROI is or the ratio of benefit to cost is the BCR. This means ROI is BCR minus 1 and BCR is ROI plus 1. ROI is 30%. So BCR is 1.3. B is incorrect and C is our answer. Let's move to the next problem. We have a project with a duration of 3 years. We need an investment of $500 at the start of the project. The project earns a constant revenue each year starting from the first year till the end of the project. The ROI for the project is 20%. Which of the following statements is true? A. The IRR for the project is also 20%. B. The NPV for the project is 20% of $500. C. The information is not enough to calculate NPV for this project. Discount rate is not provided. D. The information is not enough to calculate NPV for this project. We need the cash flows from the first to the third year. Please pause this video and try to figure out the right choice. Let's look at A. Is the IRR equal to 20%? We don't know. IRR doesn't have to be equal to ROI. IRR and ROI are totally different approaches. To find IRR, we need cash flows for year 1, 2, and 3. A is incorrect. B, C, and D, all three involve NPV. We have just two data points. Initial investment of $500 and ROI of 20%. Let's look into the ROI. ROI is benefit is the present value of all project gains. Cost is the present value of all project investments. Benefit minus cost is the NPV of the project. So, NPV is ROI multiplied by cost. $500 is the only cost for this project. Present value of this cost is also $500 because it is at time zero, at the start of the project. Therefore, NPV is 20% of $500. C and D are incorrect. Our choice is B. NPV for the project is 20% of $500.